Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel Chemical Crystal Palace. Today's topic of discussion will be Bio-Villiger rearrangement. So let's see what is Bio-Villiger rearrangement. It is an oxidation reaction in which an ester is formed from a ketone or a lactone is formed from a cyclic ketone using peroxy acids or peroxides as the reagent. Peroxy acids are also called peracids. Alright? So we take a ketone, we take a peracid, resulting we form an ester or a lactone depending on the ketone and another carboxylic acid. Now we will understand what is the meaning of lactone and peroxy acids or peracids. First, coming to peroxy acids or peracids. Peroxy acids, we can say it is an acid which contains OOH group. Alright, and what is the utility of these peroxy acids or peracids? They are very good oxidizing agents. Alright, we know that the general formula of carboxylic acid is RCOOH and the general formula of peracids will be RC double bond O, O and H. There will be an extra oxygen in peracids. Coming to the examples of peracids we will have is, you can substitute this R group with CH3 then with a methyl, then we will have peracetic acid, that is CH3 C double bond O O O H. This is peracetic acid. Another we have is this C O O O H M C P B A, also known as metachloroperbenzoic acid. Alright, this is the per acid group and the chlorine is meta to it in the meta position, so it is called metachloroperbenzoic acid or perbenzoic acid or peroxybenzoic acid, anything you can call it. Next example which we have is of peroxymonosulfuric acid. They have the structure of double bond OOH. The general formula of this is H2SO5. Chemically, it is called peroxymonosulfuric acid and the common name of it is Caro's acid. Alright, so we saw that these were some of the examples of peroxy acids or peracids. They are very, very good oxidizing agents. Now, let's see what are lactones. They are cyclic esters containing OC double bond O bond. Remember this, it's OC double bond O bond. They are formed by intramolecular esterification of the corresponding hydroxy carboxylic acids. So we will understand the formation of lactones with the help of an example. We have, think, this carboxylic acid OH and OH. This we can say it is an hydroxy carboxylic acid, the hydroxy group here and the carboxylic acid group here. Now, in the presence of H plus and heat, it leads to the formation of this ester. A six-membered ester, you can see, I told you before it was OC double bond O bond. It is OC double bond O bond. This is a lactone. Okay, how it is formed? Here, the lone pair of electrons on the hydroxy group attacks the electrophilic carbon of the acid. Then we will have a ring structure in this way. Now you'll see that the carbon is 5 coordinated, so it cannot exist in this way. So there will be a positive charge on OH. There will be a rapid removal of water, H from here, the OH part, and OH will be removed from here, minus water, a very rapid process, a simultaneous removal of H and OH from here will take place, leading to the formation of our required lactone. Alright, so this is how lactones are prepared in general. Now we will see the preparation of lactones, that is from our cyclic ketones, with the help of bioavailable rearrangement or oxidation. Another thing to be noted is 5-membered and 5-membered and 6-membered lactones. This is our 6-membered lactone which I showed before, and our 5-membered lactone we will have in this way. This is our 5-membered lactone, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5-membered lactone. These lactones are stable lactones, alright. 5 and 6-membered lactones are stable lactones. 3 and 4-membered lactones which we have are very unstable due to angle strain, and they are very reactive. In the first step, we will have the per acid, which will dissociate into the corresponding anion and the cation. The cation obviously is H plus. Then this the anion will attack the ketone. It will attack the electrophilic carbon of ketone, leading to the formation of RC minus OO. This species will be formed here. Now, what will happen is the negative charge will move here, and one of the R group will migrate to the next oxygen atom, and the bond will be cleaved from here, leading to the formation of the ester RCOOR, this part with the corresponding carboxylic acid R. Obviously, this is the carboxylate anion. Then it will accept a proton from the medium and form the carboxylic acid. Now, coming up to some of the important points of bioavailable oxidation reaction, we know that this reaction is catalyzed by acids. Electron releasing groups in the ketone and electron withdrawing groups in peracids, they accelerate the rate of the reaction. What did I say? I told electron releasing groups in ketones. In the reactant, the ketone which we had, if any electron releasing group is present in the R group of the ketone, and if any electron withdrawing group is present in the per acid, the R group of per acid, if it has an electron withdrawing group, then the rate of the reaction is accelerated. Okay, the rate of the reaction gets increased if we have this following point. The next is if we use per trifluoroacetic acid, that is CF3COOH. This is per trifluoroacetic acid. Then the reaction also takes place in a faster rate because it is a very good leaving group. So by using this reaction, that is, this reagent, that is per trifluoroacetic acid, the rate of the reaction can be enhanced. Alright, Next point which we have is the migrating group retains its configuration. The group which migrated to the adjacent oxygen atom will always retain its configuration. If it was R, then it will remain R, and if it was S, then it will remain as S. The next point we have, if the ketone is unsymmetrical, okay, in case of unsymmetrical ketones, that group will migrate which is more electron releasing. The more the electron releasing the group is attached to the ketone, that group will be migrated to the adjacent oxygen atom. Now we have some of the order of the migratory groups, that is hydrogen greater than deuterium, greater than tritium, greater than 3-degree alkyl group, which is again greater than cyclohexyl group, greater than 2-degree alkyl group, greater than the benzyl group, then which is greater than phenyl group, greater than 1-degree alkyl, greater than cyclopropyl group, greater than the methyl group. Please remember this migratory order of the groups. Next we have, if we have an electron releasing group in the aryl group, then it will facilitate the migration. Like if in the aryl group, if any electron releasing group is present in the aromatic ring, then it will facilitate the migration of that corresponding group. The order will be, the order of aryl groups migration will be, para-anisyl is greater than para-tosyl, greater than phenyl, greater than para-chlorophenyl, greater than para-nitrophenyl. Please note these orders of the migratory groups. It will be helpful for carrying out your reactions. And another point is, if in case of alkyl aryl ketones, like if you have, for example, CCH3PH, this is the alkyl part, this is the aryl part, okay, in case of alkyl aryl ketones, the aryl group will be migrated. But there is an exception, if we have in the alkyl part tertiary butyl group, then the tertiary butyl group will be migrated in place of the aryl part. So this is all for today. Please like, subscribe and share my channel. And if you have any doubt, please ask in the comment section below. Thank you.